Rodriguez played at these schools, know the intensity of this rivalry very well. Pat McAfee to kick off for West Virginia. It's a very short kick. And some confusion as Pittsburgh fields it in a very short return. So not much of a kick. But Darius Ray not able to run it out just short of the 20-yard line. So Palko and the Panthers offense look to LaRod Stevens-Holling. He's not big, and he carried the ball 32 times on Saturday in that double overtime. Collins is a future NFL fullback.
Yeah, I really like Collins. And I think Stevens-Holling, we'll see tonight how he's able to hold up. Chris, you mentioned he's a workhorse for his size at about 175 pounds. But this West Virginia defense wants to avenge the way they played 2 weeks ago against Louisville.
Pittsburgh's been a very fast starting team this season. It's Kinder in motion. Play action, they flip it short underneath. They find the fullback, Collins. He's a very effective receiver, 14 catches on the season. The West Virginia defense looking for answers in the secondary. And look at the Pittsburgh guys. Wicks, Rivers, one of those corners that must step up big. And Boo McClee from Uniontown. All these guys, it means more to them because this is their backyard.
Well, especially Eric Wicks and Vaughn Rivers going to the same high school, playing together, competing against Tyler Palko in high school, not having much success against him until last year when they beat him in a backyard brawl.
5 yards on the short pass, and now it's Stevens-Holling into traffic up the middle.
Balance within that offense.
Third, they need almost 3 yards here, and Palko will take a timeout as split backs. Quick drop, look to the flat, now fires and has a man open for a first down.
A simple read, but an accurate throw for a first down.
That's Kinder in motion. Palko hesitating. And this is what you talked about, Kirk. He throws it away instead of trying to make a crazy pass back across the field. Just gunslinger. Although I still like a quarterback that's not afraid to squeeze a ball in there and make a play. And Palko still has that momentum.
He still has that.
On second and 10, looks left. Has some room. Now fires late.
Kinder broke back, as a good receiver should do. Came back to the ball for the first down.
Panthers quickly to the line, quick tempo offense, and now Palko making some changes. Stevens-Holling, who cuts it back, goes straight ahead. 5 yards for the.
Does wonders for a team that's lost three in a row.
Hand it off to Stevens-Holling again. No gain on the right side. Quinton Andrews, very productive safety, but a guy who has been susceptible to getting beaten in the passing game up there at run support. Sets up another third down.
Andrews with a third down and 4 from the West Virginia 42.
Coming out 3 straight losses, this would mean a lot for Pittsburgh to get off to a fast start. They had been a pretty fast starting team, and then things changed with the Rutgers game. They got nothing going early. Same thing the next week against USF.
Empty set this time, Chris. 5 receivers.
Palko fires right away as they give him a huge cushion. And Stevens-Holling out.
Off balance as far as what he was expecting. And a huge cushion. And that's pitch and catch for a quarterback. And that time the tailback.
And it's no wonder he's been sharp. Palko 4 of 5 for 44 yards. Flag before the snap. Both teams pointing at each other.
Prior to the snap, offsides, number 96 on the defense, 5-yard penalty, remains first down.
This is a textbook drive for Matt Cavanaugh. You have 3 runs, 5 passes. You know, Rich Rodriguez right now concerned because this offense, this is exactly the way they wanted to script this game and start this game, with great balance and good decisions from their quarterback.
2 tight ends now on 1st and 5 after the penalty. Play action. Over the middle, into traffic, it is caught. Diving for the end zone, touchdown. No fumble.
Senior year exactly the way he needed to.
Darius Reynaud takes it in the end zone. Pat White and the Mountaineer offense will start at their 20.
Well, this is interesting here at the beginning. You're going to find Bynum here. He's going to get upfield. But Wicks is going to come in and put pressure. And he almost has a chance to get there on Tyler Palko. Right there he gets. But what I find interesting is Williams comes off of his receiver and comes over. And by coming over, makes this throw a lot tougher because he's able to recognize and read the eyes of Palko. But Palko put enough touch on the ball to allow the true freshman to go up in the air and utilize his size at 6'3 to make the catch.
And the first four completions of the drive were all pretty safe. That was a little risky down there near the goal line, but yeah, he got away with it.
Turned his back from the play, which makes it even tougher, obviously, to read the defense.
Familiar formation is White hands to Slayton, and he's stopped for no gain. This is the dynamic, super speedy backfield of the Mountaineers running behind an offensive line that is disciplined. There are three Pennsylvania guys, including the tough center we talked about, Dan Moses.
Love to watch Dan Moses. The reason Dan Moses is important is because of his block on the zone play. We'll watch it a lot tonight. On the second level, trying to get up to HB Blades and freeing up Pat White and Steve Slayton to run.
There's Slayton, kind of a stack formation in the slot behind. And White has trouble with the snap and now has to scramble. Doesn't get great footing in the backfield there and dives ahead for only 2 yards. Pittsburgh's got some excellent linebackers. HB Blades in the middle. Tommy Campbell, a speedy guy, counted on tonight. Clint Session, very productive.
It's an important game for this defense. We mentioned they lost three in a row. Last week, this team had a lead 31-17 against UConn with 8 minutes to go and fell apart. They need, again, much like their offense, to start well against the electrifying Pat White.
Here comes the noise, and White has five wide receivers on third and eight. It's a little screen. Complete, but trying to navigate traffic and get near the first down marker is Slayton. He gets just across the 30. So dangerous in space is Steve Slayton.
Three plays, Chris. Three different formations moving their All-American running back around. One time right next to Pat White. The next time stacked behind a receiver. And then that time all the way to the sideline right next to Rich Rodriguez. Just moving him around, breaking tendencies, finding different ways to get him the football.
Yet another formation now as they get the big conversion to keep Pittsburgh from building more momentum in this first quarter. White on the keeper. And they do a good job. That was the defensive emphasis, Kirk. They said it over and over in the meetings. We must not let White beat us running. They've had trouble stopping running quarterbacks. Vernon Fox there with the stop.
I love to find out from the coaches that Vernon Fox is a fifth-year senior from New Jersey, but as a fifth-year senior, he's very familiar with this offense from West Virginia. There's the three different tempos, the fast, the Indy, and the jet. When they get going in jet, we won't be able to talk much in between plays.
But it's all right.
Botts is out there because he gets the rivalry, and that was great to see him involved here early and playing with a lot of emotion and desire.
They've run the ball three times for 1 yard, so White will go deep. Has a man open, it's Slayton with the catch. Had to come back to the football, but collects it inside the 30 as he beat the safety, Sam Bryan, 43 yards.
Pitt has to be careful of playing man-to-man coverage. The safety is going to walk up, and he's going to stay man-to-man here. And I think this is a mismatch, and this is a matchup every single time. Pat White, the guy that everybody thinks can't throw, just threw the ball right down the field to his All-American running back.
So Slayton involved as a receiver early with two catches. The running game hasn't yet gotten going. They do a decent job hemming in White, but is able to kind of dart forward for about four.
I wouldn't want to put a corner on Steve Slayton, let alone a safety. That is a genuine mismatch, and that's what I think this offense, that's how it's changing as the year goes on. It's no longer just the zone read, running Steve Slayton, running Pat White, mixing in some play action. Now Paul Rhodes, as a defensive coordinator, has to worry about moving this West Virginia offense, moving Steve Slayton around. They've done it again here.
He's in the slot. Four wide receivers for White, who just takes it straight up the middle. Not his typical run, kind of a bulldozer style. He's going to be about 2 yards short of the first down. Clint Session there on the stop.
The linebackers are going to have their work cut out for him tonight. The inside linebacker, HB Blades, his job is to stay with Steve Slayton. Wherever Steve Slayton goes, His job is to follow Steve Slayton, and the outside linebackers need to contain Pat White.
Panthers crowd bringing the noise on third and three. White looks for Slayton, cuts it back, and he fights for a first down near the 15. So Matt White looking very quickly for his best buddy in the football team, and Slayton once again comes through. Big East standings, West Virginia, that loss at Louisville, but again, re-energized. Now the Mountaineers have to root for Rutgers to win their next two. That would create a three-way tie if West Virginia can knock off the Scarlet Knights down the road in Morgantown in a couple weeks, and West Virginia would have a great chance of winning that three-way tie and getting the BCS bid out of this league. This time, Slayton to the house. So Wonstadt watches as West Virginia get a big third and long conversion early in the drive. Slayton is a receiver early and a runner for the touchdown.
Able to convert a few third downs. Pat White, very, very nice drive, showing some diversity within this offense. And I thought the way they utilized Steve Slayton that time was outstanding. He caught as many passes as he ran that time down the field.
The 15-yard touchdown caps off the drive in which Slayton caught three passes for 57. Each team reaches the end zone on its first possession, 7-7. Blast into the end zone, and now Palko and the Panthers will have to try to answer. It's a low kick taken on the far side by Lowell Robinson, a dangerous return man, and Robinson shaking free. Gets around the kicker. Gets into West Virginia territory down near the third. Feel in the last few weeks.
Oh yeah, it's bad. It's tough.
So fantastic field position as Palko is going to throw on first down, looking deep and forced it. There was nobody there except a couple of white jerseys. Abraham Jones, the backup free safety, in coverage along with Vaughn Rivers.
Chris, let me go back. This is after all the variety that they were showing you. This is the read that Pat White has as a quarterback. But the blocks that he picked up from his left tackle Stanchek right here on Blades, and then Moses, we talked about being able to pick up a block on Session, and the next thing you know, look how it opened up. And it was because of the variety of the offense and the athletic ability of that big offensive line getting to the second level of those linebackers from Pitt.
Big hole, 4-3-5 speed, and it's good night very quickly. Stevens howling on the inside handoff, smothered on second long. It'll set up a third and nine now. Bobby Hathaway, one of the guys whose brother, older brother, played on the Pittsburgh side of this rivalry there for the stop.
I don't mind that Pitt decided to take a shot on first and 10. The only thing that happens, especially after the big return, the only thing that happens then is it sets up second and long, and then they decide to run. And this is the first time we've seen them now in a third and nine situation.
Yeah, the two conversions in their first drive were kind of third and medium. It's Kinder who comes in motion and comes back. Pump fake. Palko scrambling, loses the football. It's still loose. I believe the Panthers get it back. Only a short loss as they dodge trouble there. And they'll be able to attempt a field goal. It'll be a long one. Ball's at the 35-yard line.
You see the pump fake by Palko. It was taken away completely by Eric Wicks. Then the ball is a little bit loose, and the ball's all over the place. Pitt is very, very fortunate to come back with the football to give themselves a chance here on fourth down, but very loose with the ball, looking a little bit like Tyler Palko from a couple years ago, as opposed to what he's been able to do this year.
Mark Magro forcing the fumble. Pittsburgh just out of field goal range, so they'll go for it on fourth and 11. Palko fires short. It's going to be short of the first down. Steve Bukas, the tight end, but hit immediately, and he'll fall about 6 yards short of the first down. Vaughn Rivers there for the stop.
That's a great call by Jeff Castile from West Virginia, realizing that it was so far to go on fourth and 11. He decided to bring the blitz to force Palko to have to get rid of it before his receivers even got to the first down marker. So good call, works out that time for the Mountaineers.
And Bukas, the senior from here in Pittsburgh, limping off, the starting tight end, heading to the bench, favoring his ankle.
Here's Jeff Castile, the defensive coordinator.
He's an important part of the offense. We'll keep an eye on Bukas as White and the Mountaineers take over for their second possession. It is Slayton running left into a bunch of traffic, and he'll be stopped for a loss. Remington on ABC, 3:30 and 8 o'clock Eastern time. What a day, Saturday. No gain in the first down run for Slayton, so it's second and 10. And it's White on the reverse. Pitch it off to his buddy, but the Panthers all over it. Another loss. And Tommy Campbell, the linebacker.
Discipline to stay home on the reverse.
Five receivers on third and 12. White. Trying to make a move and fight for the first down. He's near it up at the 39. Clint Session there on the stop. You see the quicks of White. So he's accelerating. Appears to have the first down, judging by the spot on the yellow line.
This is the
How quick is this guy?
This is the danger for Dave Wannstedt and for all defensive coaches in deciding to rush three and drop eight. The concept makes a lot of sense on third and long. But you force him to run, and he has such acceleration that you cover everybody, and then he takes off for 12 or 13 yards.
He's a first down. You know, they've been really hurt by running quarterbacks this year.
Yeah, and that was a big problem for him last week. But this is great coverage. It's a great idea, but it's a difference maker in the backfield. And we, you know, Pat White is one of the fastest quarterbacks in the country, but there are a lot of quarterbacks hurting defenses this year by being able to run. It really has hurt Pitt. The dual threat quarterback is... Last week, D.J. Hernandez, 130 yards on the ground.
That made D.J. look like Vince Young in that double overtime loss. Growth really hurt him with a couple of scrambles in that win by USF. And here goes White up the middle. White into the secondary and down inside the 40. Boy, it's tough. You get him third and long, Kirk. They convert it. It's like a dagger for the defense.
Paul Rhodes told us that he had an idea of how to try to stop, and I figured out what his idea is. When West Virginia comes with the zone, he wants his defense flying. Here's the only drawback. Rich Rodriguez has a chance to be able to come back and have to chalk next. And when he sees what Pitt's trying to do against their zone with Steve Slayton, he runs Pat White the other way.
Incomplete look for Slayton, but he overled him on the short throw. Again, they feel Slayton is fast, Slayton is great, Slayton may get his yards. We got to control the run by the quarterback, and White already has had runs of 12 and 23 yards.
Yeah, and that's why when you look at West Virginia and you say, boy, they rush for 318, which is second in the nation. They only throw for 145. Where's the balance? Where their balance is they stretch the field horizontally and make you defend every aspect of it.
White fires to an open Darius Reynard. He slips down inside the 15. White has been very sharp as a passer in the early going.
Right now, what Pat White has decided to do is to go after the senior Sam Bryant when he gets one-on-one opportunities, and that's what he is going to do this time. He's looking into the defense, and he thinks that he's got the matchup. He looks for Bryant. He sees him. It's a zone, and he throws it right behind Bryant into the hole in the zone to his best, one of his best receivers, Reynard.
It's a first appearance for Owen Schmidt, the fullback, and he leaves White. You will lose yardage running right. Owen Schmidt, a big part of this offense as well, but he's nursing kind of an ankle injury. Rashawn Duncan, the nose tackle on the stop.
It's funny how
he's kind of favorite.
Yeah, he does look like that. But for people that have watched who are not West Virginia fans and heard a lot about Pat White and heard about his running ability and how quick he is, yeah, he's been able to run tonight seven times for 43, but he's also 4 for 5 through the air for 82 yards here in this first quarter.
Fakes the throw. and is stopped. Flying up there, the sure-handed tackler, H.B. Blades, who's one of the top tacklers in the country, 126 tackles coming into this game. Just missed being a Butkus finalist.
Yeah, it's getting a little chippy out here on the field, which you'd expect. Rayshon Bolden and Darrell Revis, who are familiar with each other. It's a backyard brawl. You're going to have some of that. It's going to be up to the officials to try to keep these teams apart from one another.
Revis close to a flag there.
Yeah, it was. Revis, by the way, one of the better cover corners this year in college football.
Mountaineers 3-for-3 on third down so far. White loops it to the end zone. Touchdown. One more time, it's Steve Slayton who reaches the end zone for the second time. This guy can throw the ball, folks.
Yeah. Hey, everybody, number 5 in white can throw the football. This kid, Pat White, just has not needed to throw it. But if you match up man-to-man, this time it was Tommy Campbell, outside linebacker, one-on-one. I got an idea, Pitt. Get out of the man coverage when it comes to covering Steve Slayton. Campbell actually is with him stride for stride, but the ball is thrown over the outside shoulder.
This is perfect.
Perfect throw. Danny Marino could not have laid that in any better. Perfect throw. And it's a touchdown.
And that's the final play of the first quarter as McAfee knocks through the conversion. Two possessions, two long drives, two touchdowns by Steve Slayton. Mountaineers lead it after 15 minutes.